Hello everyone, and welcome to the CSS Security mini briefing, where we will present a short summary of what was released today, October 10th, 2023. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. We're going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then we'll dive into a few vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities we're covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Now, before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the previous 12 months to really get a feel for how this release stacks up to previous releases. And with that, this month we have 104 new vulnerabilities that were published as part of today's release, and that's quite a bit higher than our average of right around 80 CVEs per month. Next, I'll talk about scoring, where Microsoft uses the Common Vulnerability Scoring System. This is an industry standard scoring system that allows vendors to contrast and compare different vulnerabilities across different products, different services. This is a scale between 1 and 10, with the higher the number representing the higher the risk. Now, one thing I'll note is that the CVSS score is a starting point when we talk about risk associated with each individual CVE. It includes a lot of the things that are specific to the vulnerability, but not some things that are outside of the vulnerability itself. For example, vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited out in the wild, that doesn't affect the CVSS score. Same with whether it was publicly disclosed or not. Also, the impact, whether it's remote code execution, elevation of privilege, denial of service, so on, those don't affect the score, and neither does the severity, whether it's moderate, important, or critical. It's only the 8 metrics that are published with the CVE, for example, attack vector, attack complexity, privileges required, user interaction, scope, confidentiality, integrity, and availability. The highest rated CVSS score from today's release is 9.8, which is a little bit higher than average, around 9.5. When we look at the average score across the entire release, we're right around average at 7.37. Next, I'll talk about remote code execution vulnerabilities. These are the ones that typically provide the most risk. There are 45 RCE vulnerabilities in today's release, and we've been averaging just under 29 per release over the past 13 months. There are 2 vulnerabilities that were publicly disclosed in today's release. We've been averaging just under 1. And finally, there are 3 vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited at time of release, and we've been averaging right around 2 per release. Now, when we look at just this release, those of you familiar with this slide, you'll recognize where we put the Windows products at the bottom part, and then as we move up the chart, we get into products that are not necessarily serviced every single month, and that's the case this month as well. Now, when we look at the Windows products, we've been averaging between mid-30s and mid-40s, where the older operating systems are right in that mid-30s and the newer ones in the mid-40s, and as we can see, we're well above that average, and that's partly due because the total number of CVEs are higher this month. As we move up the chart from the Windows products, we get into Microsoft Office software, where we have 4 vulnerabilities that are being addressed this month, which is a little bit lower than average. We've been averaging about just around 7.5 Office vulnerabilities per month, so almost half of our average there. Now, as we continue moving up, Microsoft Exchange Server has a vulnerability this month that's being addressed. There's a handful of vulnerabilities in developer tools such as ASP.NET, Visual Studio, .NET 6 and 7, Azure DevOps Server. They all have some vulnerabilities. There's also 3 vulnerabilities in Dynamics 365, 5 vulnerabilities in SQL Server, and 1 vulnerability in Azure HD Insight that is being addressed in today's release. So let's dive into the first vulnerability that I'll cover in today's set. This is CVE-36434. This is an elevation of privilege vulnerability. This is listed as important severity, privately disclosed, with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a base score of 9.8 on that scale of 10, so certainly elevated. the attack vector is over the network, the attack complexity is low, no privileges are required, and user interaction is not required either. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds, and as far as the affected software, it's all versions of Windows that are in support, whether that's desktop 10 and 11, and server 2012 up through the latest server 2022. Next, I'll talk to CVE-2023-35349. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability in the message queuing service. This one was privately disclosed to Microsoft with no known exploits out in the wild. This one has a base score of 9.8 on that scale of 10. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. No privileges are required for this, and no user interaction is required for this either. Now, we do have a published mitigation here, essentially that the Windows message queuing service is not enabled by default. And so if you haven't enabled this service, then your system is not vulnerable to the CVE. You can check and see if the service is running. It's called message queuing, and there's the TCP port 1801 is listening on the machine. There are no documented workarounds for this as far as the affected software. It's all versions of Windows that are currently in support, whether that's Windows 10 up through 11, server 2012, through server 2022. And the last CVE that I'll talk to, this is CVE-2023-44487. This is an important denial of service vulnerability in the HTTP2 protocol. This one was privately disclosed to Microsoft, and exploitation has been detected for this. Now, this one's a little bit different than the previous CVEs we've talked about, which are issues that are specific to Microsoft products. And this one isn't necessarily specific to Microsoft or Microsoft's implementation of HTTP2, but rather a problem with the protocol itself. And so there's an industry-wide work that's been going on here, not just Microsoft, but other IT providers have updates for their products. Now, specific to Microsoft, we've made updates available for Windows 10 through Windows 11, as well as Server 2016 through Server 2022. We've also made updates available for ASP.NET Core, .NET, and Visual Studio 2022. All the links to the updates for those products can be found in our CVE article. If you have any further questions on this, Microsoft has also published a blog about this issue, and I'll leave a link to that blog. Okay, that's all I have to talk about today. I want to thank everyone for watching the video, and I will talk to you all next month. Thank you.